Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to track your inbound marketing campaigns into GA4, Google Analytics 4, using campaign tagged URLs. You can use this technique to report on the performance of any custom campaigns you're using to send people to your website, including paid ads on social, email campaigns, and more. We're going to cover how to add campaign tags, also called UTM parameters, to URLs using Google's URL Builder. This lets you track your inbound marketing. But before we do, I want to show you the acquisition reports in GA4. This is useful because you will see where your campaigns will show up in the reports. Let's head to Google Analytics. I've already logged into Google's demo account, so let's navigate to Reports, and then select Acquisition. When you open your Google Analytics property, you'll see three reports here. There is the Acquisition Overview, which provides a top-level summary about how people are finding your website. There is the User Acquisition Report, which shows you how people first find your website, and the Traffic Acquisition Report, which shows you how people found your website to start a session. Since people can access your website multiple times using different methods, my preference is to use the Traffic Acquisition Report. So let's open this report. If we look at the table, we can see that this shows us session default channel grouping. This automatically combines different methods people use to find your website into top-level categories or groups. For example, we can see organic search, which will primarily be people finding the website on Google, but will also include other search engines, like Bing. The paid search channel will include traffic from Google Ads. And traveling down, organic social will include our free traffic from social networks. So default channel grouping provides a top-level summary for the different methods people use to find your website. Let's change this. Let's select Session Default Channel Grouping and change this to Session Source. Source shows us where people found our website. It tells us where our message was seen. We can see we have some direct traffic, traffic from Google, and traffic from other sites. For example, our Google traffic tells us that people found our website on Google. Okay, now let's change the dimension again. Let's change it to Session Medium. Medium tells us how our message was communicated. We can see we have traffic from organic, CPC, referral, and so on. For example, organic will include all of the free traffic to our website, while CPC stands for cost per click, which will be from our paid ads. We can also see referral, which is reported when someone clicks through from another website to our website. For example, if someone links to our website in a blog post, traffic from this link will be reported as a referral. And let's change the dimension to session campaign. This will include your Google Ads campaigns, if you're running ads and you have your account linked to Google Analytics. We can see these as we travel down the table. And once you're using campaign tagged URLs, you'll also see the names of your custom campaigns in this report. I want to highlight that the first four rows are for non-campaign traffic. And I want to show you two more things before we start adding campaign tags to our URLs. Let's change the dimension back to Session Source. And now let's click the plus sign to add a second dimension to the report. And let's choose Session Acquisition, and then Session Medium. This means we can see where the message was seen on the left and how the message was communicated on the right. We can now see our Google Organic and our Google CPC traffic separately in the report. If you've been using the previous version of Google Analytics, then this is like the All Traffic report in Universal Analytics. When you create your campaign tags, you'll get to define your own source, medium, and campaign name to show in these reports. And the key benefit of tracking your custom campaigns is that you get to see how people engage once they're on your website. Scrolling to the right, we can see metrics like engaged sessions, average engagement time, along with conversions and revenue. So you'll be able to report on the results from your campaigns. Now that we've looked at the default reports, it's time to start tracking our campaigns. To make this easier, Google has a tool called the Campaign URL Builder. I've included a link in the description below this video. And just to highlight, you can access this tool without logging into your account. Okay, let's take a look. Let's select GA4 on the top of the tool. To start, we need to enter the landing page we want to send people to on our website. I'm going to skip campaign ID for now. And we can then enter the campaign source, or where the message is seen. And then the campaign medium, or how the message is communicated. Next is campaign name, which is optional, but I generally recommend naming your campaign so that you can see this in your report. The campaign name lets you define the overarching initiative. There are also two additional campaign tags we can define. These are campaign term and campaign content. Campaign term is designed for tracking third-party paid search campaigns. For example, if you're running search ads on Bing, you can use this to report on the keywords that are sending traffic to your website. And campaign content lets you report on different ads or calls to action you're using in your campaigns. Whatever we define for these tags will be reported into Google Analytics when someone clicks through to our website. Ideally, we want to apply campaign tags to all of the inbound links sending traffic to our website. The more inbound links we tag, the easier it is to see how our campaigns are performing. In my example, we can see I'm going to be tracking an ad on LinkedIn that sends people to my website. I've entered linkedin.com as the source and paid as the medium. Below the campaign tags we've entered, we can see a long URL that includes the landing page we defined at the start, along with the campaign tags. We then copy and paste this URL. For our example, this would be the URL we use in our ad on LinkedIn. When people click on the link in the ad, they're directed to our landing page, and Google Analytics will report on the values for source, medium, and campaign. Let's look at another example. When it comes to campaign tagging email newsletters, we have a number of options. A popular option is to use the source to track additions of our emails. We can see in this example, we have August 2022 as the source, and the medium is email. I always recommend keeping the medium as simple as possible, so email is perfect for this campaign. Next, we have the overarching campaign name of email news, which you'll want to customize for your own campaign. We're leaving term blank because term should only be used when someone is searching, for example, in third-party cost per click campaigns. And in this example, we're using the optional content to distinguish different links within the same email newsletter. So this is one option using campaign tagged URLs to track the additions of our email newsletter, and we change the source for each addition we send. And let's look at one more example. If you're running ads on social that send traffic through to your website, you should campaign tag those links so that you can distinguish paid versus organic social traffic within your reports. Start off by naming the source as the particular social network. This should be the domain name of the social network. Then I recommend setting paid as the medium. This will allow you to differentiate from your organic social traffic, which will show up as referrals. You can then name the campaign. You'll want to customize these to describe your particular campaigns. You can then use the optional content parameter to distinguish the particular ad variation or the call to action. I also want to mention the campaign ID parameter that I skipped earlier. This parameter lets you define your own identifier for your campaign. It is optional, but if you want to import advertising cost data into Google Analytics, then you will need to define this for your campaign tagged URLs. If you'd like to learn more about data import, then I've included a link in the extra resources below this video. Once you're using campaign tagged URLs, you'll be able to see them in the acquisition reports we covered previously. Plus, you'll also be able to see them in the acquisition reports and when you create custom exploration reports in GA4. Let's head back to Google Analytics to take a look. You can view the dedicated attribution reports in GA4 by selecting Advertising. These reports consider the different marketing touchpoints people engage with before converting on your website. Let's open the Conversion Paths report. We can see this report, like the acquisition report we looked at previously, shows us the default channel grouping. But we can change this. We can see we can also choose source, medium, and campaign. So whatever you have defined as the source, medium, and campaign name for your tagged URLs can appear in this report too. Let's select campaign. In Google's demo account, we can see Google Ads campaigns included in the table. But remember, in your reports, you'll see Google Ads campaigns along with any campaign tag links that are sending traffic to your website. To learn more about attribution in GA4 and these attribution reports, check out my dedicated tutorial. I've included a link in the description below this video. Now let's create a custom exploration report for our campaign tag links. Let's navigate to Explore. And let's create a blank report. Let's name the report Custom Campaigns. And let's click the plus sign next to Dimensions. And let's search for Campaign. We can see there are a range of dimensions. If you're getting started, then I recommend using the session-based dimensions at the bottom. The dimensions listed under Attribution require that you have conversions configured in GA4. If you don't, then the report won't show you any results. So let's select Session Campaign. Now let's search for Source. Again, we can see a range of dimensions. I'm going to enable Session Source and Session Medium towards the bottom. Now let's click Import. And let's click the plus sign to the right of Metrics. I'm going to search for and enable Sessions. And Conversions. And Engagement Rate. Feel free to enable any other metrics you want included in your report. Then, when you're happy, click Import. And to create our report, we need to drag the dimensions under Rows. And the metrics under Values. We can see our report on the right. Since the first few rows aren't from our campaigns, let's add a filter to the report. To do this, let's select Filters in the second column and choose Session Campaign. Then select Does Not Match Regex and enter caret, backslash, open parenthesis, full stop, asterisk, backslash, close parenthesis, dollar sign. This will remove any values from the campaign dimension that start and end with a parenthesis. Now let's click Apply. Our report updates, and we're now focused on our custom campaigns, including any Google Ads campaigns we're running. So that's how you can track campaigns in Google Analytics using campaign tagged URLs. Remember, whatever you choose to define as the source, medium, campaign, and other tags will show up in your reports. It's always a good idea to use simple, easy to understand tags for your campaigns. Are you tracking and reporting on your campaigns in GA4? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.